Hi, this is Raman, your tutor from Alberta Real Estate School. Today we'll talk about vacancy and occupancy rates. These are topics covered in the Fundamentals of Real Estate course, as well as the Commercial Real Estate course. We'll talk about what the vacancy and occupancy rates are and how to calculate these. So let's dive in. Today we'll take a look at how to calculate vacancy and occupancy rates. First, let's take a look at vacancy rate. What is the vacancy rate? Vacancy rate is the percentage of all available units in a rental property. So let's say somebody has an apartment building. They have 8 units. So out of the 8 units, if 2 are vacant, then that would be our vacancy, 2 out of 8. So that's the vacancy. So it's the percentage of all the units that are available in the rental property. Now, how do we calculate the vacancy rate? We will take a look at what's available or divided by the total number of units. So let's say if out of 8, 2 are available. So we'll say 2 are vacant divided by 8. So that would be our vacancy rate. Let's take a look at an example. There's an apartment building which has 200 units, out of which 120 are occupied. So calculate the vacancy rate. How do we do that? So first step would be to figure out what the vacancy is. In this case, they have told us how many units are occupied. So this is where you need to be careful. If they ask you a similar question on the exam, make sure you read the question carefully. Here they have given us how many are occupied, not how many are vacant. So first step will be to calculate how many are actually vacant. So our vacancy in this case would be 200 units minus 120 that are occupied, which gives us 80 units that are unoccupied, which means they are vacant. So our vacancy in this case is 80 units. Now, in order to find the vacancy rate, we will take the 80 units and we'll divide it by the total number of units that are available in the apartment, which is 200 units. So 80 by 200, which will give us 0.40. Now we then convert that into a percentage. So we multiply it by 100 to convert it into percentage. So our vacancy rate would be 40%. So that's how we calculate the vacancy rate. Let's take a look at another example. There's a commercial building where we have 12,000 square meters available space for rent. Now, by the end of the year, 9,800 square meters is leased out. So what is the vacancy rate in this case? So again, first thing we need to find out is how much is vacant. So in this case, we have 12,000 square meters, and out of which 9,800 is leased out, which means our vacancy is 12,000 minus 9,800, which is 2,200 square meters. Then we look at vacancy rate. So in this case, 2,200, which is our vacancy, divided by the total space that is available, which is 12,000, that gives us 0.1833. Now we take that and we convert that into percentage. So we multiply that by 100, which gives us 18.33%. So the vacancy rate in this case is 18.33. So now let's take a look at occupancy rate. So occupancy is basically the opposite of vacancy. Occupancy is all the units that are actually rented out. So this is the percentage of rented or used space in a rental property. The way we calculate this, the formula would be the total rented space divided by the total space that is available. So rented space divided by total space that is available. So let's take a look at an example here. For example, same example that we looked at before. So there's an apartment building with 200 units, out of which 80 are unoccupied. So in this case, they're telling us that 80 are unoccupied, which means they are vacant. So in this case, we have to calculate the occupancy rate. So first step would be we take the 200, we minus or subtract the 80 that are unoccupied, so they are vacant, which means 120 units are occupied, right? They have been rented out. So that's the first step. Now we calculate the occupancy rate. And to do that, we will take the 120 units that are occupied divided by 200, which is the total units in that building. So in this case, our occupancy rate will be 0.60, and then we multiply that by 100 to get the percentage. So it's 60% occupancy rate. So they are basically the two sides of the same coin. Occupancy in this case is 60% and vacancy is 40%. So high rate of vacancy in this building, but that's how we would look at it. So anytime we are dealing in apartment buildings or multi-unit buildings, we have to take a look at occupancy and vacancy rate. And this is how we do that. Let's take a look at another example here. In this example, there's a commercial building that has 12,000 square meters of space available. So same question as the one before. So in this case, by the year end, 5,200 square meters is not leased out. What is the occupancy rate? So in this case, they're telling us that there's 12,000 square meters, that's the total space that's available, out of which 5,200 is remaining. That's 5,200 square meters is not occupied. So this is vacant space. So first step is to find out what is the occupancy. So in this case, the first step will be 12,000, which is the total space, minus 5,200, that is not leased out, so vacant. So our occupied space will be 6,800 square meters. The second step is we take the 6,800 square meters and we divide it by the total space that's available of 12,000 square meters, which gives us 0.5666. Third step, we take that and we multiply that by 100. So our occupancy rate ends up being 56.66 or 56.67%. So in this case, more than half of the building is occupied and the rest is vacant. So again, they are the two sides of the same coin. We can look at either the occupancy rate or the vacancy rate. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you need any extra help in preparing for your Alberta real estate exams, I invite you to visit our website, www.albertarealestateschool.com, or you can give us a call at 587-936-7779. See you next time.